Hey, who are those girls from me?
Oh my god, Josh, I love you.
We can have a great night. Cause lately, I'm glad that you're my baby. This is kind of crazy. Just tell me what you want. So hey girl, tell me what you say girl, if you say yes, it's gonna change my world, if you say no, to let you go. I just want to know where you go to prom me. 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 Where you go to prom me.
Yeah.
Welcome to the future. I just blew your
photography class. All that we've been doing is just taking like professional photos and things like that. It's only one of our classes. It's very interesting. These are my so-called friends, Jasmine, and this is Rob Desiree. He's a retiree.
What?
So I don't get the recognition?
That's cool.
Didn't work? I'm gonna get my over there and just run that way as fast as I can. It's like behind this blue car. Yeah, as fast as you can. Go! Hey, keep run back this way. It sort of worked. You done?
Yeah.
I was just gonna let you tire yourself out.
Get my face over here. Get like a good close-up of the background.
The time a freaking motorcycle comes by.
Like close-up. Not too close to my face though.
Yeah. You dare touch me. Oh my god. Okay, no, you could let go. This is embarrassing.
You're dating me. Your life is gonna be embarrassing.
If you let go now, I won't get your cupcake and put it in your. Look.
What did you do?
I didn't do anything. I just took it up. Now, are you gonna move away from the door?
No.
Move.
No.
Move. Why not?
Because this is gonna be interesting.
What's gonna be interesting? Hmm?
Don't you dare.
What? Dare what?
Don't.
What?
I swear.
I swear what?
Don't do it.
Why not?
Because I said.
So?
Don't do it.
You know I won't take quarters.
Don't do it.
Wait, move away from the door.
Why?
Move.
Why?
I'm gonna get out.
Why?
I have my reasons.
What are those reasons?
My reasons.
Well, we met because of Bobby.
And the crew. Just seeing your reaction is funny. No, yeah, just dating now, which the whole thing was honestly a big surprise, especially on that day for the two guys. And basically, I was single and I was seeing, like, I was dating. I wasn't seeing, I was dating two guys and going on dates and stuff. And then the day that he asked me out, the other guy showed up and conflict. Well, not the other guy hates me, and he's been avoiding me now, so, I'm okay with that.
I'm dating Marlene Crew, she's my girlfriend. Yeah, she's amazing, probably one of the best things that ever happened to me since I started college. All that jazz, she really took it out of my mouth. Yeah, she's just really nice, she's amazing, she's beautiful. She's just all around great. Like, it's difficult to explain.
You should open it.
And then I have like the basic of it, like the main interview that I showed you guys. I have that. If we want to add on to that, we can.
Okay.
Which is why I got all this stuff. So yeah, you said you had extra questions, right?
Yeah, they're all.
I have to leave at 1:15. I can come back.
Okay.
Around 2:10.
Okay. Do you have anything planned for today?
I work at 5, but that's...
Okay. All right, we could do everything today, or if you guys aren't busy tomorrow, we can do something like that, or something. As long as I can...
That would suck.
Yeah.
I'm basically starting from scratch.
Yeah, I have the...
Get that camera out of my face. Put that thing back where I came from, or so help
me.
Put that thing back where I came from, or so help me!
Right now, I am editing my video for Calm. I am in the last few stages of the process. I'm just putting myself in so I get some credit, because I definitely need it since I'm the only one who did any work in this group. I finally got the background music to it. I have all the clips, the pieces are all in place. I just need to put them all together in the puzzle that they fit into. I look like Kurt Cobain because my facial structure is very similar to his. I have very light brown hair. It's not blonde. I dyed it blonde, but not all of it blonde, so it has that natural light brown highlight to it. And so I think that's why people mistake me for Kurt Brown. I mean, like Kurt Cobain sometimes. I also wear flannels and black and yellow, which are some of his signature colors. And I think it's just the 5 o'clock shadow that I let grow out over a week's period. I also smoke and drink heavily, so that my voice gives it that Kurt Cobain raspy growl that he also has. Growl.
So Yvonne's doing her makeup for
trying to impress some boys in comm class.
No. My boy toy is at home.
We don't want to hear your lonely problems.
No, actually, you don't, because it hurts your feelings.
Do you guys know the...
It's like, Yvonne, look, and then it's like, what? Ah!
Oh my god.
Zach!
Zach, quick.
What's going on? What are you going to do to me?
I have a weapon. A weapon of mass destruction.
It's almost as deadly as a rubber band.
Cody, you're in the shot.
Zach. Hey,
that scared me.
I thought it was going to hit what's...
I heard that guitar playing, man. Lovely.
So what do you guys
actually... Nothing. We're disgusting stuff. Girl talk. Periods. I just finished mine.
Yeah, I know.
Did you say happy birthday?
Yes. Did you know she's starting school on the 5th?
In 5 days, yeah.
That man's head doesn't look like it belongs on his body.
She starts on the 5th, not in 5 days.
I mean,
days.
In on the 5th.
Oh, yeah.
Jeremy over there, what are you pouring in there?
What is that? It's hot chocolate.
It looks like confetti. Oh, you know Tristan's scared of confetti?
Why? Excuse me. You have to ask him. It's such a good story.
God, he's terrified.
I'll tell you the story of why I'm afraid of confetti.
My rule is, if it's your story, you guys tell it.
I am telling it. So,
tell it.
All right, so back in middle school, me and my best friend at the time were really stupid, and we wanted to go to, I can't remember, it was a Fright Dome or Adventure Dome. I think it was just Adventure Dome. And so, we go to Party City before we get there, and we buy 4 packs of confetti, and we smuggle them onto the roller coaster. So, once we get past the staff, we take them out of our shirts, and we're like, when we're ready, and it's like, ready. So, we're at the very top, and just as it's about to slide down, I take out 1 packet, and I'm struggling to get it open, so we're already going down. And I get it open, it just bursts open, all in my face. I'm just... And so it's all up in my nose, in my hair, down my shirt. I don't even know how it got in my shoe. But we're going down the loop-de-loop. And I get the other confetti pieces, hoping this will be a success this time. And I open it up, and I try and throw it back. But it's just confetti poof! Confetti poof! Confetti poof! And so all confetti just goes all over me, all over my friend. People in the back are just like, what the fuck's going on up there? And we just go through the entire roller coaster, just covered in confetti. It's glittering off like we're fucking fairies. And so, we get off the ride. We get off the ride. We're brushing ourselves off, getting it out of our hair. Staff is just like, what the hell happened to these guys? And so, we just went through the entire Adventure Dome covered in glitter, like fucking Peter Pan. I get home. Before I even enter my house, I make sure that there is no more confetti on me. I'm brushing it out, taking my shoe off. It's just dunk confetti. Like, how does that much even get in there? To this day, I still find strips of confetti laid around my house. I have showered. I've gotten new clothes. I moved! And I still find stray pieces of confetti. I'm like, no! No! I got rid of you! Get away! Back, Satan! Back! Confetti haunts you. Confetti is bad. That is why I'm afraid of confetti.
Sound check, fucker.
We got him. We got footage. We got food. We got munchies. We got notes. We got script. We have women. We got beach balls. And we got...
Ah!
Oh my gosh, Norvell.
Fucker.
You got that? What the fuck are you doing? You still work? Wow, okay.
Hand me that mic.
They didn't have any good tape.
Here.
They're out of like early.
Oh!
All they have is like orange and like. At least they're Shure mics. I mean, look at this.
People beat the fuck out of these mics. You see this? It's like they just like. Argh! Like, who eats a mic?
What is it that this desk?
Oh,
okay,
no,
do you eat mics?
Never mind.
I do. Like dicks.
Sporting goods.
Ah!
Norvell, could you come quieter?
back, scratch your back, are you done with that? I need to.
It's good. Here you go.
Thank you.
Well, today we are working on our audio project. We have to do a radio type show play.
It's a radio broadcast.
It's a radio broadcast play. We're going blog play. Haunted house. I'm Norvellius. People are other people.
And people are other
keep the camera up, man. What is wrong with you?
Nothing.
We don't have you as a cameraman for nothing.
He's got the shakes.
I'm an audio guy.
Well, you need to stop coming in here drunk, man! Get up. No! You're fired!
No!
You're fired!
Cut, see?
Oh, is that serious?
Yeah.
That's
good. Oh my god! Three.
Okay.
Okay.
Welcome to the future. I just blew your mind.
Drop it like it's hot when the bitch get an attitude.
You ready, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. She was Sally girl. Sally, oh, well, get away. I got you going down to me. Hey, all my skittle hell. Thank you. A beer all Tuesday.
Dude, guys, listen to this. Listen to this eargasm. Oh, fuck, hang on. I gotta move my fingers.
Hey, Zach, your number one fan's here.
Who's that? No way. What's up? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. Hi.
Dude, we, freaking Cody and, Austin. Yeah, Austin, they're getting guitars and we're gonna record and stuff. And
I'm leaving her here with you guys because she really wants to watch you guys play.
Well, what are you gonna do? Go do?
I'm gonna go bust a mission.
You're gonna bust a mission?
Yeah, I'm busting a mission.
Break a leg.
I gotta go pick up Dom.
Okay. Yep. Dude, go grab it. You can check out a guitar from the cage. I only brought one electric. Dude, we should fucking jam right now.
Yes.
What time is it? Oh, we got.
So I was texting Marlene yesterday, and I told her that I just got back from the hospital, but I neglected to say that I went there to go drop my aunt off because she was having chest pain and like shortness of breath. So I came back from the hospital, and I'm freaking out, so she texts me, and I'm just like, hey, and she's like, hey, what's up, and I'm like, hey, I just got back from the hospital. I just completely forgot to say, oh, I went to drop my aunt off at the hospital.
I wasn't a patient there.
Yeah, I didn't say that, like, because she FaceTimed me, and I was like, yeah, I just got back from the hospital. And she goes, what, why? I'm like, it's nothing you need to concern yourself, because, like, I wanted to say it, but, like, part of me is a dick, so I was like, yeah, don't worry about it. No, seriously, I just dropped my hand off, that's all.
You should have, like, kept it going with, like, hey, listen, we gotta have a talk sometime.
No, because
it concerns you, too.
I wouldn't do that.
Listen, it's... You should know about it, too.
No, I didn't like that. I don't roll like that.